on. I almost got it.
Rowan, you're on the air.
What? Okay. Hi, listeners. We're just, where's the...
Just intro the segment.
Granola Park Radio with Jess and Sam, Sibling Sam.
Hello, dear listeners.
Any of you are still listening after that display?
We're so glad you're here on 94.3 FM or via our simulcast on granolaparkradio.fm. That's www.granolaparkradio.fm. As usual, I'm Jess, and filling in for my usual partner, Sam, this is Sam's sibling, Sam.
Hi.
And we're so glad you're joining us here today.
You said that already.
Oh, I did? I'm sorry. I guess I'm just a little distracted.
By the bumbling intern, or by the fact that the studio is
colder
than...
It is sure cold! I think it might be, Sam, I'm very, very cold.
No thanks to Rowan.
Huh? Oh, you're welcome. What did I do?
You broke the thermostat, you sleepwalking nincompoop.
It was an honest mistake.
It really was.
Not only did you break the thermostat, you broke it during Talk and Cheese with Gloria Steinway. The entire studio smelled like hot Stilton.
I tried to fix it.
Yeah, great job. It got so cold that ice formed on the monitors.
We got to do a show in really fun parkas.
Parkas that smell like cheese.
Now, Sam, that's all in the past. The station replaced the thermostat the next day.
Yeah, how did that turn out?
Well, dear listeners, now might be a good time to tell you why we're here today. It has been 3 years since we began bringing listener-supported community radio to you, the citizens of Granola Park. And since then, it has been a real roller coaster. We've had live music, interviews with local celebrities.
Hard-hitting journalism about why there aren't more goat milk-scented soaps at the Granola Park Street Festival.
All the things our happy little community cares about. But it takes more than just love and hard work and goat milk soaps to make this all happen.
It takes money. Specifically, it takes your money.
As a nonprofit radio station, we can't advertise.
It makes the FCC grouchy and litigious.
So every year, we make our appeal to you, dear listener, for your financial contributions that buoy us up for another 12 moon cycles.
But this year is different. Rowan...
It turns out that, without a working thermostat, we're not in compliance with important regulations.
Not from the FCC, mind you. It's much worse than that. The Granola Park City Council.
That's right. We have 2 weeks to install a replacement thermostat or Granola Park radio as a station and a legal entity. We'll be forced to shutter its doors.
Jess, keep it together. You crying is like the Dalai Lama taking up arms. Portent of the end. Look, listeners, you're probably thinking, a thermostat? That's not that big of a deal. Surely a radio station can afford a new thermostat. Well, we could afford to buy and install a new thermostat, and that's what we did. But wouldn't you know, that thermostat went missing within the next 24 hours? So we installed another one. And another one. And another. Every time the thermostat went missing by the next day, and our emergency budget shot through the roof.
A tragic mystery.
I don't know how or why, but I'm convinced Rowan is responsible.
Oh, come now. The police are saying that they suspect it's the return of the holiday heister.
Who they think is my sibling, Sam, Jess.
That's right, dear listener. My regular co-host, Sam, is still on the run from the law. Who suspects Sam as the holiday heister?
Who's to say Rowan isn't the holiday heister?
I'm not.
That's just what the holiday heister would say.
Okay. Well, dear listeners, we're going to take a short break, but our operators are standing by. Call us at 240-696-4200 to pledge your donation to save Granola Park Radio.
And me.
Get over here.
Hello, Granola Park! You have been listening to Instrumental Instrumentals. This is your old friend Renoir, covering for Reginald Kingsport as he is on the road to recovery at the Jackson Pollock Memorial Rehabilitation Center. Pledge drive is this week, so station has asked all programs to reach out to listeners. I am not usually in such a position to beg for money, since as a youth I used to simply get it from gullible people online. But now I need to be a, how you say, team player. So yes, please send us money. Phone number is 240-696-4200. And I promise your money will go to the right place, which is the station, and not me. That is a Renoir promise. Before I go, I have a recording sent by our good friend Reginald Kingsport.
Ah, yes. Hello, friends. This is Reginald Kingsport, recording from the Jackson Pollock Memorial Rehabilitation Center. It has been 29 days since I started celebrity rehab, and things are looking up. I'm sleeping well, my skin tone has improved, and I'm in a position of leadership among my fellow patients. Elections for team captain of the Jackson Pollock Memorial Rehabilitation Center squash team are currently underway. And I've been told by my campaign manager, the rapper DMX, that I am but 3 points shy of leading challenger Zachary Enron. Zachary, I know you're listening. Now you know that you're counting on your charming good looks and baritone singing voice to catapult yourself to victory. But this isn't some high school musical. This is real life. Now as we speak, I am in the rehab clinic kitchen baking up my secret weapon. The Kingsport family's very own key lime pie macarons. It's a recipe so fiendishly difficult that if your breathing patterns are off while preparing them, the macarons will quite literally explode. But as my old uncle Ricardo Montalban Kingsport once told me, no one ever said celebrity rehab would be a cakewalk. Ha ha! But enough about me and my macaron machinations. It is currently pledge week at my beloved Granola Park Radio. Now, if you love shows like my own Instrumentals, Talkin' Cheese with Gloria Steinway, or All About Almonds with Filbert Bazilbert and Sandy Legume, which is quite literally the best thing on our mid-afternoon block, please, friends, I encourage you, I implore you to send what you can to the station. Maintaining the station isn't cheap. Yes, I know. Our very own tech guy has told me that he believes the station could collapse at any minute, since apparently much of it has been kept together with balsa wood and duct tape. But this only proves my point. Also, I need something to return to after rehab, after all. So, please, be generous, friends. And as for the squash team captain elections, vote for me if you want to live. This has been Reginald Kingsport, signing off.
Thank you, friend Reginald. That was very much in the spirit of what I have come to expect from you. Ah, I am Renoir, signing off of Instrumentals. Up shortly is the return of Granola Park Radio with Sam and Jess.